Welcome back, everybody. Let's play Nicktoons Attack of the Toybots for their Game Boy, of course. Today, it's time to save somebody. You have two choices. Danny. No. Jimmy. And SpongeBob. SpongeBob's gonna be the one we go with. Kind of surprising it even took this long to choose a guy since he's a fan favorite. But, actually, I mentioned last episode, I think I was playing through the next playthrough as Danny. Oh! Oh yeah, okay. Short time, okay. There wasn't any explanation for that last time I played through this, okay. So there's actually an explanation for our being able to breathe through the fairy cell, okay, cool. If you play the game, if you select SpongeBob first, then you don't get that little scene. Because SpongeBob is the guy that gets the introduction of Cosmo and Wanda, so it's just kind of assumed that you don't care about the characters not being able to breathe. But as I was saying, I think I actually played through the next playthrough with SpongeBob as my first character. Now, here's the downside to being able to move so quickly. Precision platforming, namely around these, I'd say precision, but platforming around these little, those things just kind of walk by and try to pinch you, basically. Platforming around these big spiky balls that kill you instantly is a lot harder because you're a lot less precise in how you move. So basically, it's pretty much always best now not to use my melee attack. So my melee attack makes me, it prevents me from moving for a little bit. I get move way more quickly if I'm using a ranged attack, because it takes way less time to execute. I have a very strong tendency of dying around here. You know, I just got through it flawlessly just now. I died that way too many times. Whoa! No. My first few times through here, for some reason, I just got really impatient with it. You have to time it differently, though, if you're not using a speed boost, which is probably part of the reason it was so difficult for me. Ow! Oh no, see, Tack has to pick up 25 too. Does everybody have to pick up 25? Yellow bits for that stun blast? I remember it being 20 for some reason. So it wasn't just Timmy at least. I won't remember that. Oh, dude. You even have a speed boost. You should be able to get over that more easily. A lot of this level is actually more difficult if you don't have a speed boost, because you can, with the speed boost, you can actually traverse greater distances in midair. I can't decide if I like the music in this level or not. It's kind of weird. It has, like, odd noises going on in the background every now and then, too. Because it helps a lot to have that shield. Since you're over things, it'll kill you instantly right then. I love being able to one-shot things out of range. That's amazing. What? Also, these blue crabs, they I should probably show you, actually. They try to grab you, but if they grab you, they don't actually hurt you. So they put you closer to them, and then you can just attack them. A little bit odd. I guess you just shoot something and then keep running forwards. And I'll end up hitting whatever's in front of me. That's a Timmy hole up there. Sorry how you got up there. Now I remember going up there. Actually, that's a horrible thing to do with Timmy. I'll show it off, but my god, I hated that route. That's a Timmy hole over there, too. Something over there to see if you're not Timmy. So this level I remember well, because I actually went through it earlier today. Away we go. Ah! Right. Go away. And down to the bit. I'm not sure there's a clearing in the mines on the right over there. You can just decide to jump into the land of the mines and kind of get out unharmed if you feel like it. But there's really no reason to. You can see that where the pipe ends. It's a little wrong looking. There you go. There's a tack chain. I was wondering why I didn't find all those. Checkpoint already, except I can't reach it. Another checkpoint already, okay. I'm liking this, except I can't actually reach any of them. This game's generally pretty kind of checkpoints, except for one... Except for the final level if you're playing as a particular character. Okay, so this is weird. I mentioned last episode how you can jump on top of some things when other things are the same height. So I jump on top of this. And I can't jump on top of this. And it looks like they're the exact same height. And if I'm standing on them, it also looks like they're the exact same height. It doesn't look like I'm any lower on one than on another. I don't think so, at least. But I can only jump on top of one. No idea how that works. I guess I'll jump over this one. No idea why it is the way it is. Nothing's gonna shoot me, apparently. Can't really complain about that, but it's a little bit weird. I'm wondering, if I have a speed boost with all the characters, I'll probably be able to get through the levels more quickly later on, once I've done multiple playthroughs. Where'd that enemy even go? Oh, attack. Also, there's water, I've noticed, in this area. And it's quite clearly not goo for reasons we'll see later on. But I like to think that this particular area of the Bikini Bottom is actually airtight. Oh, come on, I didn't even try to jump over you. And that we, and that there's actually water in here. It's airtight despite being in the Bikini Bottom, kind of like Sandy's Tree Dome. That's what I want to see. Point blank. Come on. Point blank use of the, what was that thing called? Pipe. Thank you. What will my final ability be, actually? Here's what that will be. I think we'll figure out, or I think we'll learn in this episode. Some missing tack. See, there's water over there. Won't quite make sense if you're still underwater like normal in Bikini Bottom. Dude, attack, please. Those red crabs throw nets at you. Octopus! Like that. The nets don't actually do anything, they just trap you for a little bit. And here you are at the end, run. Okay, the joys of being Timmy. Amazing, Timmy, great start. Seems a pretty well-quantified experience of being Timmy in this game. I kind of find myself wondering how many times I'll die as Timmy compared to other characters. Timmy, go down! There's also so many little cracks you can get into in this level as Timmy that you can't get into as anybody else, but there's no point in it. Like you might have seen just a moment ago, those, little Timmy holes underneath those platforms. There's no real reason for it, but... Oh! Kind of surprised I didn't just end up dying there by just jumping out over a bunch of mines. That's usually how I end up dying in that area right then, actually. Aha! So I'm 2 for 3, apparently, with that part that I usually die in. Time and time again. This cooldown on Cosmo Wanda is horrible. Can't kill anything now. Well, I can't prevent anything from hurting me. I can't kill anything ever. And that was a little bit too close. About a centimeter away from my face. Now, can you not be right where you... Right where I need to... Contact damage of all things. Yeah, Timmy can't do anything about these, enemies shooting things either. There you go. I also had trouble with that, but whatever. I'm apparently not having trouble with anything anymore. Can you kill, enemies that are... Come on, I was trying to- I was mashing the left trigger! I was wondering if I could kill enemies that had been turned into furniture. I was mashing the left trigger and nothing was happening. Timmy is so impaired in this game. And killing anything takes so much time for you to be able to do much of anything about it. Alright, Cess part's great. Yes, this thing is going to shoot at me. And no, I can't get... I don't know what I even expect to do there. I don't think I can get through that without getting hurt. Because I can't get through that electric thing as a frog without getting hurt. But if I don't turn into a frog, I end up touching the turrets. I don't know. Seashell Drive, whatever this place is called. I can't... I'm pretty sure there's a name for the road that Snowdrop lives on. But nobody ever mentions that. I think it was just mentioned in a simple episode or something, or maybe in a video game. Hitboxes for the frog are kind of weird when it comes to the frog's horizontal movement. So there's just really just this little frog gauntlet if you're playing as Timmy that you can go through. I'm pretty sure you can actually get through this part of the level and just bypass that part, but I always like to do it like that anyways. By always, I mean like the two times I've played through it, including just now. I guess he's the only character that's actually vulnerable to being grabbed by that blue crab. Because if he got grabbed, he won't be able to react in time by summoning Cosmo and Wanda. Any other character could actually do something about that, though. To me, you are a weakling in every sense. And it makes sense he's this random 10-year-old who's weak, but doesn't mean it's not annoying. Right. Timmy can nearly outrun a speeding bullet, apparently. And his power is something that actively makes him weaker. It's not any better for Timmy. What? I can also apparently do that. So that's a little glitch, apparently. It's cool. I mean, I want to get up there. I do want to get up there. Game, let me do that. That's my hope. That's my biggest dream now. Come on, I know I can do a single jump out of here. I've done it. I've done a single jump out of this cubby. I've proven it to be possible. Now, I need to do a single jump and then time the second jump, though. Yes! Breaking the game in minute ways. What did I even just do? Where should I be right now in relation to where I am? I'm not even quite sure. Well, I should be... Did I just do what I think I did? I actually managed to sequence break something by going up there. But, I don't know, where am I supposed to be? I was just supposed to go into this, I guess. So I kinda did skip something. That's always satisfying. Fairly oddly satisfying. Why is this frog capable of running and jumping at the same time? This frog has some serious issues. I can go down there, or I can go through a Timmy hole. I will choose the Timmy hole. This is going to end up being a longer episode, by the way. You probably already realized. Oh, guys. Since I'm going to just levelize a lot of characters. Later episodes will probably end up getting a little bit shortened by having certain things cut out. I'm not sure if I've already gone through a level as a certain character before. I'll have to see. But I'll also get the characters through levels more quickly because I'll be more familiar with them, and I'll be more familiar with all the characters will have speed boosts. As long as the speed boosts aren't actively making the game harder for me, at least. Why? Hi, guy whose name I do not in any way, shape, or form remember from No Monsters. So this is probably gonna be the next episode will probably be the longest one by a good margin. But this one should only be the second longest, I think. I hope it would be, at least. Because we're only like halfway through the level now, actually, aren't we? Or halfway through the episode, that is. Since we have... Stop following me, please! Since we're about at the end of the level and we have Danny and Sundrum to play through this level as. Something through contact damage. And just run!
Run, Timmy, run!
Timmy doesn't even get a mech to drive through that part. It's kind of annoying. Oh god, guys. Alright. You wouldn't think that it would take so much time to play through a Game Boy game. Nice little platformer on the Game Boy. A licensed platform, the Game Boy, no less. But that's pretty much just because there's a ton of padding in the game. I forgot that I had to take little shots to get rid of these things. Oh, come on. I should destroy these things. More easily, at least. It also looks like you're punching something, at least. At close range. If you're not saying the, little goo balls fly from his hands. So I was actually 2 for 4, wasn't I, earlier? I managed to get across this thing, it's Timmy. 3 for 4? 3 for 4! The crab. You're probably the most boring version of the crab, as reflected by your boring color. Danny, please! I don't have time for this. Are you supposed to- It seems kind of- it makes sense in some senses that characters would face consequences from falling a few meters down. At the same time, these are characters that are actually used- some of these characters are used to this type of thing. Like, it's no big deal for Danny to be falling twice his own height. I'm pretty sure. Life a lot easier. Hi. Come on. The way he picks up his foot, though, like it just had something that caused a sharp pain in his foot, as one might expect. Such a thing to do. It just amuses me sometimes how reactions look relatively realistic to the things that are happening. Hi. Danny's sprite in this game is kind of lean compared to other characters. It's kind of weird. Although that is just kind of how Danny is compared to other characters anyways, I guess. He is, in fact, relatively lean. Everybody else has weird proportions. Tack has proportions like a child, Slendrob's a bloody sponge. Timmy is... 10. What?! I keep forgetting, Danny has these really annoying vertical, his vertical in general, his hitbox is big, so a single jump like that can easily, yeah, hurting me. Also, there's this weird thing with this game where how long you press a button actually does determine how high you jump, which is cool, but not something you've seen this kind of game. Can't really make use of it if you don't realize it's there. Thanks. Whoa, is that like this? The sound of me going out of my ghost, my intangible form? There's your little woo sound right there. This could be not. I just find all these assholes and destroy all these turrets, and they're such a pain half the time. speed! Oh, I saw they were there, but I didn't... Okay, well, why not? I bother doing anything about them for some reason. I could have shot those all down. Actually, I'm pretty sure that's what I did last time through the level. There we go. I do also have a stun blast when I need it. Not that helps with the turrets, for some reason. Come on. Haha. I don't need ghost powers. That works. Somehow. Alright, stop that. Not quite sure what the intention was when it came when these things were built the way they are. Since some things are just like stuck inside of each other practically. But no. That just works for a ghost. Hi. Beaver. Did that knock me out of my intangible form? Falling too far. It's interesting. Oops. Also, you can't shoot if you're inside of something. So Danny literally just can't attack at all. You hear this noise? But you can if you go tangible again and then start punching. Oh wait, can you not attack at all if you're intangible? Oh, so was that the reason I... So that is the actual effect of being intangible. I really just never even tried to attack on intangible, apparently. Well, that's why I got hurt when I was intangible earlier. When I was next to an enemy. Interesting thing to learn just now. Not really sure why I won't be able to attack at all. Especially since they can still touch me, but whatever. And we're most of the way through the level again. And then we'll just have one last run through the level as SpongeBob. Come on! Damn, your hitboxes are... At least the right thing about you. And a game like this, that is a very bad thing. Stop that. Now then, if we could please... No, if we could please jump when I press the A button. Before going off the ledge, things could be relatively nice. And we could not have enemies that create things I don't really have any way of avoiding either. There. Now, as we tried before, these enemies flinch. Why could they do that? There we go. Duh. You can crouch under these things, but if you're not crouching, they will end up hitting you. As you just saw. Stop that. Alright. Danny! Apparently made me invincible to other hazards, apparently. Okay, and now one more go. SpongeBob! Oh yeah. Oh wait! Okay, so SpongeBob can literally blow bubbles anywhere on this level. That's really cool. I never really tried that. Yeah, when SpongeBob's underwater, he can blow bubbles. Which is cool. And the idea is that it traps enemies, although it's not there's not much point to it, because SpongeBob actually has a really good attack. Now he has probably the game's best melee attack, in fact. It's quick and it does a normal amount of damage. Normal meaning that it can one-shot anything. In fact, his first upgrade is what seems to be completely useless. He has a different animation for his air attack. Not sure what the point of that is. In fact, it makes it more difficult to work with because it changes its hitbox in a really awkward way. But SpongeBob can get helpful things, he can destroy things. It's actually a favorable to play as. There's not really much of a point to using the bubble, because it moves so slowly. and it immobilizes the enemies, and there's not really much point in doing it. You can just outright punch them out. Some drop books. Very curious for a moment. Oh, see, that's the most beautiful animation when he's just floating on a fan. I don't know what the point of that is, but it's appealing, whatever it is. Ah, 4-4-4! Very close, but 4-4-4. It's actually playing a SpongeBob a lot, honestly. Enemy is trapped. Not too useful. Whatever. Okay, stop floating up. Actually, like, if I had my upgraded air attack just then when I tried to hit that turret, I don't think I would have hit, which is really weird. The air attack is just weird that SpongeBob gets. I kind of wish I didn't get it, because actually, I have a really hard time finding any benefit in it. I'm pretty sure there was literally none. Other than the fact that it's the new animation, which looks cool, but its hitbox is worse, because its vertical hitbox is really limited. There you go. Those are firing asynchronously, so it's kind of difficult to do anything. Alright, though. So you don't really get to see SpongeBob's special ability in this portion of Bikini Bottom. We'll see it once you get to the next part, in the factory. You can also attack twice in a quick succession. There's not really ever any purpose for that, because he just literally one-shots everything. SpongeBob is actually quite nice to play as. I'm kind of rocking through this level too, for that very reason. SpongeBob's honestly a good character. Possibly my favorite. Like, even right now, despite the fact that he doesn't have any upgrades, I'm actually enjoying playing as him right now a lot. Except for the fact that I'm enjoying that he doesn't have his upgraded air attack. He has really good hitbox with his attack too, like that right there. Actually hits things under him too. Now though, we're above water. So to support my theory of this place being airtight, I can't blow bubbles anymore. But SpongeBob, as Cosmo says, with a line break for some reason, can go straight through water. He actually sinks like a rock for some reason. Like other characters can swim. Opta! Well, he also sinks like a rock if you happen to step on a landmine. Except it's in the ocean.
Opta! Stop that!
Sponge! No. There you go. Fool you twice, Sponge. SpongeBob actually gets to see the first red crab in level 2. Hi. Alright. There you go. Okay. So, because SpongeBob can literally just outright enter certain areas that are completely inaccessible to other characters, he tends to actually have the most unique, or the most in terms of unique levels too. Or his levels tend to have the most unique paths, because they don't very often, don't cross into the same paths that other characters have as often. The paths actually look odd. Like, you look like you're dried out, actually. Oh, well, now you don't really look like much of anything at all. So good at taking out turrets, it's incredibly convenient. Stop that. He has the most amusing too. He has the best sprite when he's in a tank. I don't know why, but the pure sadism on the Sponge's face is the most enjoyable part to me. Anything over to the side? Not that I can reach. So he doesn't have any ranged attacks. At least not, on land. SpongeBob. But his melee is good enough that it really doesn't matter. I don't think. Sindor is just a good character to be. And that'll finally be it for this episode. Let's play. No, that's actually we have a boss. Never mind. It's probably best. Attacks probably want better characters to be for this too, because shoot this thing out of range. But yeah, basically, this thing will just kind of randomly come up to you and shoot with its tentacles. It'll just kind of like move its tentacles in your jaw direction. Like every boss fight, there are tanks if you want to have something pad your health, or if you're playing as something that can't actually deal damage directly, like Timmy. But you can just do this basically if you happen to be Danny or Tech. Alright, let's. Suddenly that thing appears. And it shoots lasers, but. Eh. And its lasers are kind of okay at hitting you, I guess, but it's not really matters. Because it's still really weak. And then there's just a key. I mean, you didn't really, you don't even hit the robot or anything. It's just like a little Robotnik fight. In fact, that SpongeBob's pants even look like the egg carrier. You're not fighting the man, but the machine. Or in this case, not the sponge machine, but the pants machine. The round pants machine. It is a party. Yep. Means party later. Sheep Rhino! That sounds amazing. Oh. I'm pretty sure attack button in this case actually means the right trigger. That's what I meant when I played a SpongeBob. I don't know why. But alright. Hooray! Who will it be? I wonder who! The dramatic tension is killing me. So, as you pretty much heard, next episode will be the last episode of the main, well, of the first playthrough of this game. But there will be more stuff to see, because as this game claims there to be, there's stuff to see if you actually manage to 100% the game as every character. So, next episode will be the final episode, but will be the final episode of this playthrough. So, sit tight for the final episode of, let's play some, Nicktoons. Attack of the Toybots for the GBA! Haha! Who will we save? Who will it be? Let's leave Cosmo in wondering. Bye, guys!